story, the tragic life, passionate poetry of the great Sylvia Plath about home. No one would be so sick and tasteless as to make jokes, right? Anyway, this comes from the Parade magazine, question and answer. When are Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan going to make another one of those wonderful romantic comedies? Like Sleepless in Seattle or You've Got Mail? Tom and Meg will certainly be looking for scripts they can do together. But meanwhile, they each have projects going on their own. But both going for the cameras and biopics. Tom playing Dean Martin. Well, Meg goes like Sylvia Plath. Give up those adorable Tom and Meg romances? It's too much to ask. But there's a better way. Sylvie loses the Mademoiselle competition. To make it up, her parents take her for a week in Havana. She meets Dino, handsome, gifted, unfulfilled. She tells him he needs a partner, a wisecracker, zany. What about you, sweetheart? Dean asks, eyes twinkling. Her parents take her back to Boston. She's shoved into Wellesley, Lowell, poetry, Ted Hughes. Dean meets Jerry, who looks sort of like Sylvia without her vivacious wit. Life pulls them apart, their chance at happiness lost. Forever? It looks that way for Sylvia. One day she decides to end it all. She goes to turn on the gas jet, but by mistake hits the radio. Hears through the static, everybody loves Dean! He's playing the Albert Hall with Jerry. She leaves Ted and his mistress minding the kids. She takes a cab, goes backstage to find Dean in his dressing room, a gun to his head. She pries it gently from his fingers. They talk all night, walking beside the Thames. Dean tells her he can't stand another night with Jerry. They've found each other. Jerry goes off to France. Dean and Sylvia heads for Vegas, where he teaches her how to laugh again. She writes new material for him, brings a touch of profundity to his act. Who in a boot hits your eye like a big daddy? It's a happy ending for Sylvia, and there's a lesson here for all of us. I'm afraid nobody else would do this. So I brought the Who is Tad Richards. this comes from a product that's on the supermarket shelves, one's in the generic section of the supermarket. And it was a generic version of Ritz crackers, and it's called All Purpose Snack Crackers. So this is wonderful. A snack cracker will do anything. All-purpose snack crackers. You can think of Richards that way. In a pinch, you can use it to change a tile or spackle a cracked in plaster. He makes a dandy contraceptive device. And it's almost guaranteed to fit anywhere without prescription, although, worst caution, may leave crumbs. And of course, he's delicious with me. I did ask a friend to come and play the guitar for me for a couple of things, and this is my dear friend Peter Lang of a good 50 years.
Oh, don't say that.
And good to be. Somewhere here I have my programs, what I'm actually going to do, and yes, I also had asked a few people. I'd ask Mr. Berner, Mr. Haskins, and Ms. Klein if they would come up and sing backup for me on this one.
We're doing the tragic
here. All right.
This is the tragic polka. And
don't fall off.
Your part.
No one can
your part will be. Doing the tragic polka.
All right.
Doing the tragic polka.
let me set a key so we're all singing the same key.
Okay.
Ready? Anytime.
First you kill your father, then you off the king. Doing the tragic polka. Then your mistress checks up while she's still got on your ring. Doing the tragic polka. Watch your lover sinking in a spiraling descent. Doing it for him, but the money belongs to him.
Sorry about that.
Find his honor and the trade is red you meant. Doing the tragic polka. Find out that you're married to your mother. Doing the tragic polka. Twirl it when they tell you that you can't injure your brother. Doing the tragic polka. Your son has snatched your wife away and laid her in the shade. You could have won the duel except for poison off the blade. Your husband is a loser, but attention must be paid. Doing the tragic polka. Sour, throw yourself beneath a tree. Doing the tragic polka. With gentle gavel pistols, you can put one in your brain. Doing the tragic polka. A bunch of hungry kids are gonna eat you because it's hot out. You think your sweetie's dead, and so your wife, your life, you're gonna blot out. No matter how you wash your hands, you just can't get that spot out. Doing the tragic polka.